So hello students, the topic that we are doing today is the introduction of the trigonometry. It is the class 10th topic. It is the chapter 8 in the NCERT book. So let me introduce trigonometry to you first. So trigonometry is basically, it is the study of the right angle triangles. There are some trigonometric ratios. They help us to identify the relationship between the angles and the sides. That is why we study the trigonometric ratios. Since it is the introduction, you have to know there are 6 different trigonometric ratios. We will study all of them one by one. They're very, very simple. Just listen. First is the sine theta. Sine theta, suppose this is your theta. Okay. There are 3 sides in the triangle. Here is a theta. The side opposite to the theta, we will call it the opposite side. The side near to the theta, we will call it the adjacent side. And the longest side, that is called the hypotenuse. Okay, so the side opposite, we will call it the opposite side. I am not calling it height or anything or base. We will call it opposite and adjacent sides. Okay, so here is theta. This is opposite side and this is adjacent side and this is hypotenuse. So first is the sine theta. Sine theta, it is the measure of opposite upon hypotenuse. Simple, opposite upon hypotenuse. Okay. And cosine theta, that is the cos theta, which we call in the short form cos theta. It is the measure of adjacent upon hypotenuse. It is the measure of adjacent upon hypotenuse. You just have to remember these 2 thetas, because all of the other we can derive the formula from them only. Very simple. Okay, so sine theta is the opposite upon hypotenuse and the cos theta is the adjacent upon hypotenuse. This is my theta. Okay, now third is the tangent theta. We also call it the tan theta. Tan theta is simply sine theta divided by cos theta. Here you can see sine theta divided by cos theta. Now if I put the formula, this is opposite upon hypotenuse divided by adjacent upon hypotenuse. Now you must have studied that how do you divide the fractions. You simply reciprocal the second one. So if I reciprocal it, it becomes hypotenuse upon adjacent. The hypotenuse and the hypotenuse will cut each other and I'm left with this opposite upon adjacent. Simple. So you know the value of sine theta now, you know the value of cos theta now, and you know the value of tan theta now. The other 3 thetas, that is the cosec theta, sec theta and cot theta, their values are, they are simply the reciprocals of the thetas that we have already studied. So cosecant theta, which is also called the cosec theta, it is the reciprocal of sine theta. Simple. So we know the value of sine theta, it was opposite upon hypotenuse. So when I reciprocal it, it becomes hypotenuse upon opposite. Simple. Similarly, secant theta, which is called the sec theta, it is the opposite of cos theta. Now we know the value of cos theta, it is adjacent upon hypotenuse. So the sec theta becomes hypotenuse upon adjacent. Right? And cot theta, that is the cotangent theta, it is the opposite of tan theta. So tan theta is opposite upon adjacent. This becomes adjacent upon opposite. Simple. Now, to explain them more clearly, we have an example over here. Let's say this is a right angle triangle. And we have been, let's say this is the right angle triangle. And we have the values. This is my theta. So the height is given to me 8, the base is given 6 and the hypotenuse is 10. So here is the theta, the opposite side is this one, so 8 is the opposite side. The adjacent side is this one, so 6 is the adjacent side and this is the longest side, so this is the hypotenuse. Okay. So now let's calculate the values. Sine theta is opposite upon hypotenuse, which is 8 upon 10. Divide them, the answer is 4 upon 5. Cos theta is adjacent upon hypotenuse, that is 6 upon 10. The value is 3 upon 5. Tan theta is opposite upon adjacent. If you divide them, you get 8 upon 6. The answer is 4 upon 3. Cosec theta is simply the opposite of sine theta. Sine theta was 4 upon 5. Cosec theta is 5 upon 4. The opposite. Sec theta is the opposite of cos theta. So cos theta was 3 upon 5. So sec theta becomes 5 upon 3. Cot theta is the opposite of tan theta. Tan theta was 4 upon 3. So cot theta is 3 upon 4. Simple. That is how you calculate all the trigonometric ratios. So this is it. In the next video, I will do some of the questions of the NCERT first exercise. So we will try some questions and then the trigonometric ratios will be more clear to you. Okay. Till then, try a few questions yourself and put in the comment section that have you understood the topic clearly or not. And just wait for the next video. Thank you.